package, layer package.
About the ability to create layer packages. Why do you create layer packages?
Oh, yeah.
Huh? Easily accessible? Yeah, what is the difference between an LPK file and an MXD file?
LPK has your data inside, and a map file points to your data.
Yeah, exactly. So MXD is just a link to your database, which is a GDB file. So when you're sharing your MXD, you need to share the entire GDB database. However, when you create a layer package, an LPK file, and you share that file, the person can actually open and see the analysis or any changes that you made to that layer without the need to have access to the entire your database,
right? What did you do number two? Site coordinate system.
Is there anyone that is not from this classroom? That
how
is
did
here?
You do that? Is it in the book?
No, I got the one.
Oh, you don't
see it. You there? Yeah.
How did you know that?
Okay, guys. So, that's about it. Layer package will
Ron
be
was on you?
No, it's not
to share the file without the need to share the entire view database.
Thanks.
Today we're going to be starting assignment four.
Layers, packages.
It's a relatively easy assignment. Once I do it with you, the board is going to be very simple. But I want you to try it on your own first. So the probably. For 30 to 40 minutes, I want you to work on it without me explaining what needs to be done. Then I'll come to the board, I'll do it with you. You can actually do it after me once I show you how to do it. We are not submitting assignment 4 that one. We're waiting until next week. We're going to use the same file. We're going to do assignment 4 that 2. And then from there, we're going to submit the entire assignment. Okay? What is assignment 4 that about? The learning outcomes. We're going to be learning how to symbolize a map using quantitative attributes. So imagine that, just recall. Remember that we had the US States map, and we went into the attribute tables, and we had a lot of information in there. We had information about population of 2007, population of 2010. I think in assignment 2, we made an analysis between race. White people, black people, Hispanic people, Asian people, do you guys remember that? So imagine that I want to create a map showing the United States of America, and I wanted to show in different color the states that have most Hispanic people, for example. This is going to be what we're going to be learning today. So we're going to be learning how to symbolize a map using quantitative attributes. We're also going to learn how to create custom numeric classes. So let's say that I want to show in green states that have between 0 to 50,000 people that are Hispanic descendant or something like that. We're also going to learn how to change the coordinate system. So I'm not really familiar with the Canadian high school system, but if you guys took a class called geography, we probably learned the different ways that you can represent a map, and different ways to project a map. Does anyone have an idea what I'm talking about? So you can have a map in different projections. There's many, many of those. And we're going to learn today how do we change this projection type on GIS. Okay?
Forget.
So we're going to learn that as well. As for the textbook, we're probably going to be using page 59 and 62. Those are the main important pages that you're going to be looking for while you're going to be doing here. As I said, I want you to try it on your own first, but I want to get set up the file with you, and we're going to take it from there, okay? So what I'm going to be doing here basically is, an assignment is already posted on Blackboard, I don't know if you've seen it, but this is. So what I